I don't know if you know this. Thor News is for winners, and that's why you're here.
Hit the button, baby.
We are trying to continue to get our citizens to safety. We have gone door to door in the areas in and around the river with our mandatory evacuation and pressing upon people the importance to get to higher ground. And so we'll continue to get that message out there.
Do you think that river is still rising at this hour?
Yes, sir. The National Weather Service has predicted that it will actually crest tomorrow morning at around 62 feet, which is almost 10 feet higher than we had a couple of years ago with Hurricane Matthew. And Hurricane Matthew left significant flooding damage in and around our city and our community.
Did you say 62? 6-2?
Yes, sir. 62. And flood stage is at 50 for this particular river. And so we surpassed that yesterday. And 62 will be the peak that they're estimating.
Wow. My, oh, my.
We appreciate you all helping us get the word out to keep our citizens safe.
This is a bad situation that is getting worse, and it is a multi-day event that will bring flooding and problems to multiple areas. So we got levees breaking. We have unusual event at a nuclear power plant in North Carolina. We have dams in danger, and the governor saying that river levels won't have peaked until tomorrow. So this is an ongoing disaster that is not going away. It's brought to us by the wonderful Bobby Storm 10 minutes ago. Temporary levee break, not good. It's brought to us by Michael Ventrice. This is Northeast Cape Fear River near Burgau, for clarification. Just broke record flood stage at 22.5 feet and is predicted to remain record stage for 5 days. Florence has passed, but the storm's wet footprint remains. This is brought to us by Ginger Z. The highest rain total from North Carolina is 35.93 inches near Elizabethtown. This breaks the record for highest rainfall total from a tropical cyclone for the state. South Carolina broke that record too with 23.63 inches in near Loras. That's a lot of places flooding or in flood watch. I don't know how you cut your butter, but that's buttery. That's definitely buttery. This storm is still a beast as it heads north and is going to cause problems in areas that have had major flooding already. So I now call upon you to be your best self and do what you can to help. And just stay cool, man. Magna Hut. All right. Everybody stay cool. Be cool. I'm on this shit like stink. Wait, what? And this bit of wisdom brought to us by @Turnbolt11 on Twitter. I will say this, though. Politics have been transcended. Both mindsets have come together for the safety of everyone. We didn't block each other and snip rudely, ignore pertinent questions, or act like children. Everyone pulled resources and knowledge together to get the word out. Yeah, weather will do that. And that's one of the reasons I've chosen it, is because it is one of the things that affects all of us. Ron Canarella. 7-day forecast from National Weather Service of Cape Fear River height. You should already have this link, but here's the lock one prediction. You're going to lose a lot of bridges. Get to higher ground by tomorrow. It's brought to us by Steph at 55 Mickelson, or Michelson. Michael Jordan's from North Carolina. I like him. Wilmington, North Carolina, inaccessible by land. Unbelievable. About 1,000 road closures. Wilmington, inaccessible by land. Don't travel. Let responders work. Sections of I-95 and 40 flooded. No reopen time until crews assess damage. I mean, this is a serious situation, dude. And I do not understand how Americans can be concerned about anything political right now. Anyway, I want everybody to stay cool. I'll be covering this all day as usual. This was brought to us by Michael Ventrice and David Bogdond. The aftermath of Hurricane Florence 2018. It's a bad scene, man. It's a bad scene.
So here we go again.